If you want to shine like the sun, first you have to burn like it. That is a famous inspirational quote from the Hitler. I like Hitler not just because what he has done, he's definitely done wrong, but he's very motivational, you know. He's kind of person who tried to rule, the power to win, the power to conquer. Anyway guys, that's your personal preference. So this video is exclusively about the Xiaomi Mi A1. So in the past video, we have seen a speed test performance comparison of the Xiaomi Mi A1 compared with the Android Nougat 7.1.2. So there's a definitely performance improvement. We save a lot of times in doing real world time tests. So this video will show you the 20 plus Android Oreo feature that are there on the Xiaomi Mi A1 now. The new version of Android definitely brings so many features, but few features are still exclusive to the device hardware specific. For example, AR stickers are for this Pixel phones, and Google camera is exclusive for the Pixel phone. So, but still, most of the features you are going to get on the Mi A1, and also Xiaomi just did some kind of tweaks for their own handsets too. So this video will guide you so many important tips and tricks, like how to enable some specific settings by default. Autofill service is disabled. I will show you how to enable that, how to use picture in picture mode and a smart text selection. There's so many cool tips and tricks for your Mi A1, and I guess this is one of the first budget device to get the official Android Oreo update. There are some few devices which are running the beta version of the Oreo, like the Nokia 6, but you are the first person, if you own the Xiaomi Mi A1 in the budget segment, to get the official Android Oreo update. Anyway guys, let's get started and see the 20 plus Android Oreo feature in the Xiaomi Mi A1. Android Oreo supports the adaptive icon feature, which means the same application can take different set of icons without even, you know, being updated with the app developer. So as you can see right now, I am the square girl. So I've just selected the icon, my phone got rebooted. Just wanted to show you, that's why I just included it here. Anyway guys, so we've got our icons changed to the circle. Earlier it was square girl. Now you can see it is completely rounded pixel based icons. Again changing back into the square girl, so it looks like the normal one what we have got. So square plus circle, that means square girl. Now changing back again to teardrop, something, some new icon pack. So this is how you can change your icon packs. Now you guys know that, you know, Android Nougat supports also app shortcut. Now it has been redesigned here, you can see it looks different. If the application had the widget support, it will show you widget option here. The look is different, and you know, you got the rearrange icon options are there. There's an app info section is here. So each application shows you different types of app shortcut. Now app shortcuts are there. Now guys, take a look on closer here. So if you can easily take out any app shortcut, and you can create a widget here. You don't need to go inside the widget section to create an individual widget, even though app doesn't support. So as you can see, you can directly create a tweet widget shortcut of the Twitter application in case you're tweeting a lot of information. For example, this is the battery stats. I can move it to desktop. You can easily see the battery section. So it's a quick way. It's saving a lot of times for you. Even it has more options too. Now notification dot feature is very important here. Now on the Android Oreo, in case you got any notification, you can see there is a dot matching to the app icon. Now you can easily preview the what is the notification here. Exactly, you can see here, you don't need to slide down here. That's how this is your Twitter. And if you just slide down, that's the same notification I saw back on this one here, app on the dots and preview. So for example, all the applications operation, it shows different kinds of view notification. So take a look on the close area. This is a place I will explain you what is that. You can see there is a 3 number written. That means 3 applications are installed recently, and the last application installed the Google Assistant, and before that it was FileScope, and it was before that it was Notes, the third application. So you can read all details just by in the preview section here. Now quick settings also got a lot of revamp here. It now has a new different color. It's kind of milky white. Earlier it was a little bit of gray color, but now it is completely milky white. And icons are changed to, for example, mobile data. I'm not showing here, but it is changed. Bluetooth is changed here. Different icons are being changed here. So on the downside, settings has been moved on the lower end section. This gear icon later was on the top side. You got this expand toggle here. So kind of bits of refinement and kind of painting job, you can say that. Now there is an app notification control feature too. As you can see, there is a persistent notification here. So in case you don't want to get any notifications, you know, like that, you do have control whether you want to see the dots preview also, in case you completely want to disable to that. Earlier it was kind of different way, in a power control notification or just based on app way only. Now it has categorized to dots and something like that. Now the compact notification. So Oreo notifications groups are very optimized. It is now taking less bit of space. There is a new different animations, as you can see, if you just slide down all the notification easily, you can see individual icons are in good color. They looks nice, and you can easily expand in that way. So right here, if you just minimize them again, they will just clutter back. So it's just simplified and compacted, looks more beautiful and organized in a way. There is this notification snooze feature. In some application, you are not able to make it disable, or you just want to just snooze it for a couple of hours or minutes. You want to get them checked later. As you can see, once you slide it down, you can see there is a snooze option. So max you can do up to 2 hours. So I believe it should be at least for a day like that, because you know, 2 hours is not just too much. At least, you know, everything is good in case you have more options. So this is nice feature. You can easily snooze it for a couple of hours, 30 minutes, 15 minutes. So it depends on application type to type. If notification is completely persistent, you cannot do that, and you can just have to disable that. For example, this is Android system notification. You cannot do it from here. You have to just click that here and you have to go that. So some different way of sorting organization. Now on the quick settings, you can directly jump to the clock. So this is in the Pixel stock Android, as you can see. Now here on the Android one, you can again do the same thing. So it's a quick way. You can just go and use your clock and calendar in case you're using a lot of clocks option. So I'm using it each day, just why I thought to show you here. Now Android one also got a built-in file manager, which is very great. I'll tell you why. Compared to the stock Android, it even doesn't have this built-in file manager. I guess it was there back in the preview, but they just removed it. I don't know, maybe people are not using it, but you know, hey guys, it's good to have it in case you already have some kind of, in case you're out of internet, you can easily use such kind of file manager for faster copy paste. So this is on the Pixel 2 XL, it's not there on the stock Android phone. The complete main system settings has been redesigned, and I'm very, very happy to see that. Like, it's not like OnePlus, they just make it to the Nougat makeover, just we just no new look. So it has same thing. The Android one offers with the Xiaomi now the Mi services option, which is just diagnostic information section. There is nothing new here. There is something new, I will tell you guys later. So it looks more or less exactly same as the stock Android. Everything is just organized. This is inside the system. It is now compacted. Every respective thing has been moved to the respective column. You can easily find anything. You don't need to navigate a lot of places. Next, we got the night light feature. So it has been more optimized. Now you got the custom schedule option. You can just select based on sunrise to sunset. You can easily take from here and whatever time you think. I'm using this sunrise to sunset, which is, it is nice for me based on the my current location. It just changes according to the sun. Industry, you should set it to 20%. It's nice. It won't, you know, hurt your eyes. It's good to have in the night. Battery management statics also got a lot of improvements. You can have the peaks like earlier. And also battery life has also been improved here. So going inside, now, you know, by default on the Nougat, it shows the mix of the Android system also and user application also. But now everything is separate here. You can exactly see user application in case you wanted to check the system application also. You can just enable device usage. It will show you Bluetooth screen, how much things you are using. But you know, you cannot control on those things. You just have to skip with them. You can minimize that, like where you can control the sleep notification, everything else. And also you do have the battery automation. You can control which applications to run the background or not. You can just control in that way. Now, if you're using a lot of Mi handset or if you're using wired headsets, you can easily have a Mi, you know, audio enhancer. Like here you can see, just you have to plug your headphone jack and you have to select this Mi sound enhancer. So probably it is just for Mi based headphones only. So because it is a Mi device, so definitely they should have to give their own stuff too. Anyway, in case you have normal headphones, you can just select general. You should be seeing hearing some better sound quality and sound output. Nice thing. Next, we got a built-in anti-malware, which is in the form of the Google Play Protect. So whatever application you're installing, Google itself scans it. It just updates the database regularly from the Google servers. So till now, I haven't found any malware because I used to sideload very less APKs and even they are from the trusted server. But you know, it should be always great in case you have something as a defense line installed on your phone. So built-in malware is a great thing. Maybe in the future, you should be seeing some built-in antivirus too. As of now, it's just limited to the malware. Good thing here. There is a storage manager section inside the setting, which is a kind of a dynamic way to control, you know, and check which files are using, which files you're not using. So there is a storage manager option. You should have to turn that on. So a lot of things are there. So once you turn that on, it will show you individual application and the type of applications and what category of storage are being consumed, system files, other applications, media. Free space, once you use this thing, it will just tell you what are the files you haven't used from so long time based on thing you can decide, you know, views to copy and forgot. It's a good way to check dynamically by itself by the Android, like, hey, this file is very old, delete it, save some space. Now you got some good Bluetooth codecs too, in case your handsets, in case your wireless headphones supports this thing. For example, the latest Android Oreo supports the aptX and aptX HD, but you have to enable developer option. So check how to enable that thing. So that's how it is connected. I'm just going inside the developer option. Here it is, developer option. check for this Bluetooth audio codec. You got a lot of whole new thing codecs. So aptX is very nice. My Sennheiser supports aptX HD. It gives a better audio quality in case your handset supported. Philips will also support that. Good way to check that. Now you guys know that on the Android Nougat, when you're sideloading an application that is APK, it is system wide. Once you enable this unknown sources, it is applicable for all the places from where you're going to install the APK. But here on the Android Oreo, it is based on application to application. That means, for example, in case I'm trying from a file manager, so only this file manager will be given rights to install from unknown sources, not the other application. For example, Chrome, it need to explicitly enable again, but it is good. It is application wise, individual by. Now we got some new emojis here. So Pixel 1, I like it a lot. People hate it, but I like it because, you know, it's a big, I can easily see, you know, my eyes are not too very, very sharp, so I need to look at them closely. I can easily see what are those emojis. So good way to check, see new emojis. The blob emojis got redesigned too. Last is fingerprint gestures. You can see I have shown you a lot of times here. So you can now swipe down with this thing and you can just see the notification like that. Just swipe it down. So it is as of now limited to this thing here. I hope this should be given some further option like double tap to do some else action. If you just swipe from, you know, right to left, there should be some other further action. It is just top to down. I don't know why it is not like that. So maybe if you're using something, why not just use some extra bit of actions to do some, allow some other gestures to, who knows, it should come. App installation progress. Now you can see the Nougat installation is, you know, kind of unknown infinity way. You cannot check it. But here on the Oreo, you have a progressive installation. That is, you can exactly see how much percentage of the installation is left for you. As you can see, I'm just going to stall an application here, Tatali, a new Google Triangle application. So here you can see the progressive application bar. Progress bar is progressive. It can easily show you like how much percentage time is left for you. Just showing you again. So here you can see. Once I click on the stall button, it is just shows the constant progressive status bar. Very, very good thing. Optimize, you know, it's a nice way. Now this is very, very important, guys. Picture in picture mode, highly requested feature. Now once you go inside this picture in picture mode setting, so supported application as of now they will show you here. I haven't all the application, but you know, list keeps on increasing. So I'm just going to show you guys how you can use inside the map. So open the maps application and just set your destination where you wanted to drive or navigate. So once you set that, once you're going to start those things, just click on the home button. You can see your maps is minimized now. You can use it. Here it is like that. So you can close it in that way. Just click it. It will a little bit of zoom. Any application you will use, it will just there. You can minimize Twitter and the maps and together. Very, very good way to use the Android Oreo picture in picture. I'm using it daily on my Chrome. Yeah. Speaking of the Chrome, YouTube doesn't support it here. YouTube Red needs it, but India, it doesn't have this feature. So you have to play your favorite video inside this Chrome only, and make sure to use Chrome inside this desktop mode, otherwise it won't work. So select desktop side, and once you start playing your video, you see there is an option which maximizes the video right here, that the square one next to the resolution. Click here, and after that, once you start a video start playing, just press the home button like that, and your video will minimize. So you have to use Chrome as of now to play the video and work in side by side. Hopefully in the future YouTube should support that thing. Anyway guys, it should come very soon. Next is smart text selection. Now, you know, whatever things you are typed, in case you're selecting those texts, so Google will try to analyze it. If it found something sensible, it will show the respective application. So I just selected some phone number. It shows me like this is a phone number. So do you want to open the phone application? It will just show you shortcut from there. Good thing is that. So guys, next we have the Autofill service. So it's like your password manager. You can see that by default it is disabled here, Autofill with Google. Every company does offer that. Google, Samsung, Huawei, they are just trying to give their own file manager. So I will recommend you to use Google one. So be sure to go to the settings applications section and find an application called as a Google Play services. Check here, Google Play services. So inside that you have to go to this storage section. So permission should be given properly, make sure about that. Inside the storage section, you have to click on the manage space, and here it is. You need to clear all the data. Don't worry, it will just clear the cache. You just have to select the backup account again. After that, you should have to clear the cache also. Once it is done, make sure all the permission is given and just reboot your phone. Once you're back online, you can see here inside this Autofill service, the Autofill with Google is already enabled. Since I'm already using it, I'm just going to give you guys a quick demo how does it work. So I have configured in almost all the devices I do have. So I'm just going to add a new Instagram account. So here, as you can see, so since I've already used it, it will show me tab to let Google fill this form for you. That is, do you want us to show the saved username password? Once you start typing, it will show me all the username password and not the password. Once you select username, it will show the password. You don't need to remember the passwords now. There is a Wi-Fi improvement in terms of statics and details. Once you go to the Wi-Fi, quick shortcut here. That's how you can go inside the settings. So click on the connected network. You can see it shows a lot of information now. Basically, you can see all the details on the advanced, but here you can see here in the same way. It looks more optimized and nice. And one thing I don't like, why the Android one doesn't have this inside the Wi-Fi, for instance, the turn on Wi-Fi automatically. It's good way. Sometimes I forgot to turn off the mobile data and it just saves my mobile data. It's a good way to have this feature. So guys, those are the some features, tips and tricks for Mi A1. So stay tuned to the channel. So whatever devices are going to come in this 2018, like the Nokia 6, Moto GS, and Xiaomi devices, I will definitely show you the unboxing and the comparison with the Mi A1, whether you should be upgrading your Mi A1 to those devices or not. So once again guys, thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys did enjoy it. This is Saurabh. I'll catch you very soon. Have a great day.